Carolina by one. Both teams still trying to get a feel for the game.
See the post play down inside. See Robbie Eggers goes for the steal. Everything really good about that. You would like to see Gladness maybe having a body back up against that defender so he knows where he is. A lot of times defenders inside, if you don't get your body up against them, they'll try to get around you and knock that ball away from you once in a while. But it's a good play, good quickness by William Gladness.
A low scoring game because of some poor early shooting. Gladness outside, hits that one 15 feet.
If he could continue to hit that shot, then he becomes a very, very difficult player to play against because then it really opens his game up inside. Look at the strength Scheffler shows inside, just using that strength down low. But if Gladness can hit that outside jump shot, makes him a very difficult player to deal with.
Screen down for the screener that time, but Indiana covered it well. Shivers couldn't get the ball. Here's Eggers inside. Count it, and he'll get a free throw.
Good strong post play by Robbie Eggers. Inside, Indiana's got to get over there and help out just a little bit better. You can see he gets good post position. Nice job of clearing himself. Gladness definitely grabs him by the arm. He'll get a three-point try. Michael Lewis and Kirk Hastings coming into the game for Indiana. But it was interesting, Coach Knight talked about his defensive team feeling like they needed to talk more on defense. I know when I played here, that was one thing he always stressed so much. Never felt like he heard enough talk out there. And especially with a younger team, everybody's so into concentrating on what they're doing, they forget to help one another out, and it sure makes defense a lot easier to play when you talk and let people know what's coming.
Former IU player Brian Evans behind the IU bench, you saw him in that last shot.
Nice job of getting the ball in the middle against the zone. Good patience, moving the ball around.
Lead pass, Scheffler has it, and Hastings with the foul.
Good defense by Indiana, but you just got to know where he is on the basketball floor. He's a very smart player. You can see he comes down. Now watch how he uses his body. You know, just holds you there. He doesn't push off. He just holds you there until the ball's up over his head. Then he goes and gets it. Kirk Hastings with the foul.
Saw Scheffler in the locker room before the game, and I told him that he looked good in red. And he looked good because didn't say Purdue across the front of his jersey. He's got a chuckle.
I'll tell you what, he's an outstanding young man. My brother played baseball at Purdue and was there during that time. And I never have ever heard anything but great things about Stephen Scheffler and all the wonderful things he's been as a player and as a student athlete.
Played on Seattle Supersonics 96 final NBA team in the finals, A.J. Guyton.
There's the type of things you talk about A.J. Guyton. He has got to do those type of things each and every time down the floor. Once in a while down the floor, he gets to wandering, and he doesn't get much out of his ability.
Eggers, that fadeaway, we saw many times here at IU. Tied up at 12 now, and Hastings with the foul. Eggers in position to take the charge.
Talked about Hastings wanting to get him to play a little stronger. Nice to see him come down and bang on somebody. But the only thing Coach Knight's going to see right here, you can see him in the middle of your screen right here. Robbie Eggers sets up. You can't just come down and run over him. You got to see who's set up. You kind of run around him right there. It's a good, smart play by Robbie Eggers.
Hey, Hastings could learn a lot today playing against Eggers. Daniels out front. Shivers, their offensive player. Record draws that assignment. Michael shoot from the outside.
See Michael Lewis very aware of what Hackham can do, and Robbie Eggers knocks down a three.
That's 8 points now for...
And I think the last 8 points, that was an excellent in feed inside, and Hastings has got to catch that ball. Trying to get the ball inside to him.
That's David Shivers, hits from the outside. Suddenly at 18-12, Athletes in Action lead.
After it was just tied,
we can add that up pretty quick, can we?
Yes, we can. This is where Indiana needs to show some patience, spread things out, try to get an easy bucket going to the basket.
Good hands by A.J.
We've got to protect the ball a little bit better.
And a slap that time. Washington took it right into the basket that time.
You'd like to see right there, he made a nice shot fake, got Eggers up in the air, and that's when you'd really like to kind of see him lean into him and get the ball up on the basket. He still gets the foul. But when you make that fake and you get that man to commit himself up in the air, that's when you take advantage of him, because basically you lean into him, he's going to fall on you.
Substitution, number 34. Now we'll have to check the roster. We're not showing a 34. Joshua King. And four athletes in action. And 51 is Matt Garrison, 10-2. And they reverse this score to get that 6-point lead.
Indiana doing a lot of screening. Need to set good, solid screens. Also up to the screener. 34, they're going to get with the bump.
Joshua King just in the lineup. Draws a foul. Number 14, Matt Hellman. He's a familiar face from the University of Illinois. 98 grad.
Spent some time on this floor also. Played for Illinois. Their starting point guard. Very successful team over there last year.
Gladness in the lineup again. Washington out. Michael Lewis into Haston. Shot is off. And Record can't come away with it. 1-on-3 for that rebound. Garrison 51. Hellman, Lewis on him.
See if you hear much talking outside or inside playing defense. You can see right there, offensive rebounds. Again, something that really kills. And yeah, let's see if Guyton does anything with the ball right here.
Gets it to Lewis, and a three-pointer by Lewis.
That's the thing that's going to get Michael Lewis playing time. He's got to come in and knock that jumper down against zones. He's got to take advantage of his shooting ability. The guy that shot the ball is obviously in the state of Indiana was the leading scorer. He's got to come in and have the confidence to start knocking that shot down consistently.
Dane Fife will be back in when we come back. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN+. And Brian Evans had a shot there just a minute ago of him. Low-scoring game, Ted, and Indiana has not been able to score on the inside, and really the outside opportunities haven't come as much as they'd hoped.
I think that's good. I mean, it's a low-scoring game. That's last year, Coach Knight talked about athletes in action scoring 42 points in the first 9.5 minutes. He said they were on average to go for about 168. So we're about to that 9.5 minute right now, and they're at 18. He's surely much more pleased with his defense. That's a travel.
It is. A few too many steps that time. Julian Wingfield, 6'4", from Missouri. And Indiana gets down the turnover. Fife and Lewis, Recker, Kirk Haston, and Gladness inside. Oh, good high-low.
Good pass right there. He's got to get that ball in the basket. I mean, he's right up there over the rim. He jumps so well. He's so quick. He's got it right up there. Got to get that ball, but that's two good, quick, sharp passes that get you an easy layup. That's when you got to take advantage of.
Good double team by Gladness, prevented that inside shot. Okay. And Indiana's got it.
See what they got.
Lewis down quickly. Good play, Michael Lewis for two.
Recognition, coach talks about recognition right there. There's not many guys that Michael Lewis can take it in and take it up over, but he knows Matt Heldman's probably the one guy on the floor he can. He was the guy inside, so he takes it inside, gets an easy basket. Good recognition by the entire team right there. Good easy basket for Indiana.
Five quick points. Indiana down just one. Dan Krept from Northwestern. And the steal. Fife all alone. Faked the shot and drew the foul.
I hope that he got a chance to try to shoot the basketball. Otherwise, they're going to have it out of bounds. I mean, you'd like to see him after. Good steal right here by Lewis coming over and helping. You can see he's going to throw it out in front, which is an excellent play. Okay, he's going to make the fake. Now, you got to act like you're going to shoot. Even though the guy's coming down on you, you got to get that ball like it's going up towards the basket so you get two free throws.
This 20-second timeout is brought to you by Spies. And let's take a look at our newcomers' report card. Their very first game, Kirk Hastings played well. Lynn Washington, pretty good job. Fife played excellent. Guy, only 3 minutes. Hornsby and Odell did not dress in that ballgame.
I thought the, you know, we talked a lot about Hastings and Fife, but I thought Lynn Washington really did a nice job. He didn't get probably the minutes, but as far as what Indiana really needs, I mean, a guy that'll get down inside and bang people and do some of the dirty work down inside, I thought he did an excellent job.
And we'll see him do that throughout the course of the year. Kreft and Gladness are spoken to by one of the referees. Ready to go. Lewis, a cut to the hoop. And Recker lets it go into the backcourt. He couldn't touch it on this side, then go get it. That's why he let it go over his head. Double team. And a foul. Okay, this athlete's an action team much quicker than the Australian team. Much bigger. Bigger inside. More experience in the college ranks, the American college ranks.
Really got it packed in, so you're going to have to spread out. You're going to have to get some good ball fakes. You get open on the wing, either that or you get open down in the corner.
Easton open.
They're called traveling. That's where you got to have a good base, get your feet spread out. He's got his feet right next to one another. There's no way he can move inside, and he ends up traveling.
Six turnovers now for Indiana.
Indiana much more aggressive on the basketball, really out playing the basketball.
Kreft inside.
And you see right there, Haston again, when this guy gets the ball, if the man still has his dribble alive, you better keep one hand down on his hip. You can't just put both hands up. Good job by Indiana going after the basketball on the board.
Gladness got that one after a good defensive play. Haston, and the shot good.
He's got a quick little release inside when he's able to clear himself. The problem he has is when people really body up against him and bang up against him, he doesn't seem to be real comfortable down inside.
Indiana now by one. Seven straight points for the Hoosiers. Lewis kept it away.
Sure, athletes in action doesn't want to see Kreft handling the basketball right down there. Right there is a turnover. Turned into an easy basket for athletes in action. Coach Knight talking to Luke Brecker about grabbing the basketball.
Julian Winfield got that one.
Wow, is he quick inside. Excellent job by Indiana getting the ball down quickly. Gladness does nothing but flash up into the middle, catch, turn, and go to the basket. And he's just way too quick for Kreft inside. See Indiana make an excellent play, and then Record doesn't handle the basketball. That's where, you know, before you can turn and go the other way, you got to have the basketball and control the basketball. And that turns into a turnover and two easy points for athletes in action.
Larry Richardson now in the game for Indiana. A.J. Guyton checks back in now. Shivers back in for athletes in action. 22, good-looking player there, 6'5". From Southern Methodist, graduated in 93, scoring 18 and a half a game.
I would think this would be more of Larry Richardson's type game. The other night was a pretty quick up and down the floor. This is going to be one where he and Scheffler, I imagine you'll see some banging going on inside with those two.
Joshua King with that move. Played on that Rhode Island team from last year for Coach Jim Herrick. Richardson turns and shoots it. A little long.
Yeah, I think the one thing right there, you can see they come back down and get the basket. Coach Knight, usually once you get in the game, he'd like to see you run up down the floor two or three times before you touch the ball the first time and fire up a little jump shot. He had good position down inside, not a bad shot, but probably a better decision to kind of get involved in the game, throw a couple screens before you start taking jump shots.
AJ brings it back out, 15 seconds to shoot.
And AJ's got to recognize that he's got a bigger man on him, and he needs to take him to the basket. He needs to clear some people out and get him down inside, take him to the basket rather than just dribbling around the perimeter.
Good shot fake there. Got around him on the dribble. Garrison with the board. Hellman out quickly. Scheffler down with Lewis guarding him. Now Lewis releases. Nearly steals, and the lay-in off, scramble, A.J. has it.
see what he does right here. You see how he really doesn't force the action. He doesn't make Matt Heldman play him. You'd really like to see him, gonna call travel. He's off balance again, but you'd really like to see AJ take the basketball inside.
Athletes in action now, the three-point lead. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus. Action lead it by three. Indiana moved several players in and out. We expect to see that this year quite a bit, wear that opponent down.
Take a look at AJ, and I know I've been harping on the thing of him, you know, he's got to take the ball to the basket, but you just think of a guy like Michael Jordan, the best player on the floor, coming down with the great back cut right there. Great recognition, good back cut. Indiana come out of the defensively, really overplaying. But AJ's got to force things, got to make things happen for this Indiana team. He's the best athlete on the floor, their best scorer, and he's got to make some things happen.
Good move by Washington. And he gets it to Richardson and a foul. It'll be a great learning game for Indiana's big guys inside. They're playing some guys bigger, stronger, more experienced, and they're going to learn a lot.
I think Washington does some really good things inside. Rob Turner came in the other night, really finished the game off strong against North Melbourne, really got into the game. If you're playing for this Indiana team, he's one of the guys you'd really like to get into the basketball game because he can really put some points on the board in a hurry.
There's Rob, 23.
I think if I was a big guy, I'd be looking to screen his man and try to get him in. Wow, what a great shot.
Washington, a jump hook that time with the right hand.
Shivers, very intelligent player, really clears himself, doesn't try to get too quick or do anything too fast. Imagine we're going to get Richardson down inside. He and Scheffler are going to be banging down inside.
Looks like some old Big Ten basketball there. I think Larry's going to learn a lot from a guy like Scheffler in there.
But the thing that he would learn most from him is Scheffler's just a very smart player. He doesn't force things. He's not going to go across the lane and knock you down, but he's going to go across the lane and get position.
Traveling called on Shivers that time. Nine turnovers now for the athletes in action. So both teams turning that ball over a lot more than they'd like to. Crowd getting a little anxious now. Robbie Eggers will check back in. Turner moves to the hoop and gets it to go.
That's the type of things I'm talking about. When he comes in the game, you want to look for him as a big guy. Start screening him. Get him open. Get him involved in the game. I mean, he can get 20 points up on the board in no time. I mean, he's just so active. Once he gets into the game, he's really a good player.
Nearly stolen away by Garrison that time on the rebound. Bounce pass off of Richardson. Ball had some steam on it that time.
Did have some steam, but Larry Richardson down inside calling for the basketball. If you're calling for it, one of the guards is good enough to give it to you. You better catch it.
Eggers already above his season's average. After just his first stint of duty in this game, he's back in. 6:13 left, first half. And there's Eggers. 44. Scheffler way outside.
Not a hander. Not a guy that's going to handle the ball a lot, but right there, gets all the way to the basket.
Shivers again on the travel.
I think I'd have to question that travel. I thought that was a pretty good move by Shivers. Got all the way down the lane.
Three ties, six lead changes. Indiana's largest lead is five. Right now they trail by one. Cross court. Richardson will take that shot. Easy rebound for Scheffler.
I think Steve Scheffler will continue to let him probably pop out and take that shot until he's convinced that he can hit it five out of six times.
And another travel three times in a row now. Athletes in action turned over. Number 15, David Daniels in.
Really good player, very solid, strong, smart player. You can see the crowd very anxious, wanting this team to get a lead, but this kind of game against this type of team is what will make this team better. I mean, playing North Melbourne is not going to make this team a lot better. It makes them feel good about themselves. It makes the crowd feel good about them, but it's not going to make them any better. Playing athletes in action, this type of team is going to make them better.
And now traveling again by Shivers. He can't believe it.
I think he did travel right there. Now, the one down the lane, I'd have to question. I thought that was a pretty good move. But right there, I think he took the extra hop. Take a look at it right here. He catches it kind of, you can see, before he got the ball on the floor, a lot of officials might let you get by with that. There's not much going on in the offense. You've got to set more solid type screens inside.
Ball tipped. Coming up at halftime, stay with us as we'll cover the stats from the first half, some highlights, and our IU update. All at halftime.
See, Rob Turner has a bigger guy, Garrison, on him right now. This is where he needs to get out in the open and be able to work.
Eggers on the floor for that ball. And the foul on Eggers.
Steve Wilmer, what he's basically saying to Robbie Eggers is, you give me no choice. I mean, it was a good hustle play. I don't want to call the foul, but when you knock the guy down, I've got to call the tripping foul.
Steve Wilmer, of course, from neighboring Columbus, brought his entourage of bodyguards to make sure he gets out of the building okay. The guy said, as Wilmer goes on, he needs more and more people to protect him as he leaves the building. Great guy.
He is a great guy. The one thing I really like about him, he's a guy that loves his job, and he really works hard at it.
I think he
really tries to improve every night he's out there. He's not out there, to show off. He's out there to do an excellent job, and he tries to get better each and every night he's out there.
He played the game inside, so he knows what he's looking for in fouls. He referees a lot of games. You'll see him several nights a week this winter.
But he's already been to El Paso and SMU this week, so done more traveling than we'll probably do all year, lads.
Daniels outside misses. Look at the rebounding, though. Eggers.
Look at Washington. That's all got to do by Washington fighting for that basketball. Even though he doesn't come up for it, he continues to block out and continues to fight. Bad pass right there.
Stolen easily by Shivers.
You can see Shivers just walked the freshman right into that play right there. You can see it coming and just kind of laid back and waited on it.
Indiana turnover.
This is going to be two. You let Scheffler get inside. The guy's the NCAA career leader in field goal percentage, up around 69%. You let him get the ball in there, he is going to make you pay. And he continues to lay off Richardson until he shows him that he can hit that jump shot. Indiana, very compact, right on the lane. There's not a lot of action right there. You can see Recker comes off and shoots the jump shot, but offensively, Indiana, not a lot going on.
First two for Recker. He's looked to score. That's the lineup in there for Indiana.
You know, Rob Turner has got to get out on Robbie Eggers. Rob Turner is a much quicker player than Robbie Eggers. You can see he comes off and doesn't really get out there and pressure the basketball. The other night, the thing that was so good for Indiana, there was pressure everywhere on wherever the basketball was.
Luke Jimin is in for the first time tonight. He replaces Dean Fife.
Take a look at the foul. I didn't really see it down inside, but again, you see Larry Richardson. He's got his hands up high. See how Steve Scheffler clears himself and uses his strength down low, his legs, so it doesn't look like he's fouled. Larry Richardson's got his hands up on his shoulders, up above his waist, and it looks like he's grabbing and fouling all over. Steve, that's the difference in Steve Scheffler. Smart guy, and really knows how to use his body down low.
Those two free throws build the lead to three. For athletes in action, you're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus. First half, Indiana still in the ball game. They trail it by three. Very competitive game here. Good learning experience for a young Hoosier team.
I think Indiana's doing a nice job. They're hanging in the basketball game. Obviously a much more experienced team and athletes in action. They've played a number of games, but Indiana's hanging in there. I mean, you're not always going to play well offensively. You're not always going to make the shots. You're going to turn the ball over. But defensively, you can keep yourself in the basketball game. Indiana hasn't played really well here tonight, but they're still in the basketball game. They're only down three.
Remember last year, 10 minutes ago in the first half, Athletes in Action had 40 points. They've got 30 now with 3:20 left. So Indiana's defense picked up quite a bit.
See, that zone continues to stay really packed in. That's a quick shot. Steve Scheffler banged him, shook his head, said, yep, I got him.
The Recker will go to the line. He's really looking to score a lot more the second time that he's been in the game.
I mean, on that sequence right there, wasn't really anything open out on the perimeter, so Luke Recker did a nice job, went down inside, popped up to the basketball, got it, used his quickness against the bigger guy. Those are the little type of things Coach talked about, recognition. Don't just stand in the same place and do the same thing. I mean, do some different things.
First free throw Indiana's made in the ball game. The 3-12. So all their scoring coming from the perimeter as opposed to the free throw.
What's Luke Gimmel is?
You don't want to run into that pick.
No.
Shooters outside.
That one. They come out and clear their guard right away.
Rob Turner, he answers that one. Turner was ready.
This one, you feel like they better hit it. That's a pretty quick three.
Hey, Turner's that kind of guy, though. You know, that's
he is.
That Kentucky game.
There's no question that he is that type of player, and you've got to get him involved in the basketball game.
Here's steal by Recker. Crowd getting into it a little bit here. They want Indiana to take this lead. 2.5 minutes left. Inside, Eggers.
Bobby Eggers has really done a nice job. Played very solid down inside.
Shot clock was at 4. Hackham took that one from the outside. Good defense that time by Indiana. Recker on the move. Got a smaller man on him. Let's see if he goes inside. Richardson, the jump shot.
Excellent shot by Larry Richardson. Earlier, I got on him a little bit because he took the quick jump shot, but that's a shot he can hit. There's no question about that. Coach won't be happy about letting the little guard get all the way to the basket, but again, it's all set up by a good screen by Steve Scheffler up top. Nobody can get around him, and guard's able to get all the way to the basket.
Indiana got lead there for one possession. Athletes in action take it back now.
Keep hanging in there. Keep running your offense. You can see they're back man-to-man. Let's see what type of recognition Indiana has.
Recker, tough shot. Bounces it off of Scheffler. He's quick on that shot. 43 in the lineup for Indiana. Jared Odom, first time we've seen him this year. 6'8", 210 from Oak Hill High School in Converse.
There's probably not a lot of people in this building that know where Converse, Indiana is, but I do.
And where would that be, Ted?
Well, it's up by Wapikon.
Well, now we know.
Yeah.
Now we know where
sure,
it is.
Hey, you just got to know where it is.
Yeah.
He comes right in and answers right away. The guy that can shoot the basketball. How about that?
Bobby Eggers hits two more.
No, Jared Odlick gets two.
I'm sorry.
Quick two for Indiana.
Odlick, good score. Led the state in scoring his junior year. Here's Scheffler.
Look how he clears himself. You wonder how he gets shot up, but there's no way to get close to the guy because he just clears you out.
Missed that short banker. Recker to the hoop. Oh, and Washington nearly had it.
Still, it's a good follow. He's where he should be.
Shivers ready.
He'll make you pay.
Robbie Eggers misses.
Look at that, though. There's five Indiana guys to rebound the basketball. I think that's the most important thing we've probably seen. Five guys going to the basket to rebound.
Small team now for Indiana.
Good screen by Odell right there.
Guyton had time to set for that shot.
Good recognition by Odell. You can see he came up, set the little screen, didn't get a real good screen, but enough of a body on the defense to free A.J. Guyton. He doesn't need a lot of room. Good pressure by Washington. Gets it buried right in his face.
That's Daniels, David Daniels from the outside. And Indiana does not get the shot away before the half. So very hard play first half. Both teams. And Indiana is going to go in leading by one at the half. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus.
This is both teams turning the ball over. You can see neither team getting to the free throw line, so they're taking a lot of outside shots. Three-point field goes, both teams shooting the ball well. But again, the rebounds, Indiana doing a very good job against a bigger, stronger team, but turnovers. You know, both teams, they've scored 11 and 15 points respectively off of turnovers, so whatever team starts handling the basketball better is probably going to come out the victor in the second half. Take a look at the leading scorer, Shivers. No surprises, the leading scorer for Athletes in Action, Eggers. Robbie Eggers scored those 8 points like on three consecutive trips down the floor, and Stephen Scheffler with 8 for Indiana. William Gladness, Washington. Indiana continues to have a lot of people scoring points, which I think it'll really pay off as the season goes along.
When we come back, we'll have second half action. It's Indiana by one. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus.
The all-new Mitsubishi Galant. Totally new styling, nicely equipped at $17,990.
Getting dressed for work used to be simple. Blue or gray. But now that the work environment has become, well, more relaxed, dressing's followed suit. Which is why we can help you look like you're ready for business, no matter what type of business you're in. With, of course, a few possible exceptions.
The Men's Warehouse.
You're going to like the way you look. I guarantee it.
1-800-776-SUIT.
After they're licensed, Great Clips stylists get advanced training on all the professional hair care products they offer.
They give me a great choice of products.
They become experts at knowing when to use a mousse instead of a gel and what conditioner to use with a clarifying shampoo.
They know what they're doing.
They might just recommend a daily bodifying shampoo, or they could suggest a weekly reparative shampoo.
They recommend what's right for me.
That's the long and short of great hair care. At Great Clips, guaranteed satisfaction, guaranteed style.
In 1996, what restaurant was voted best overall restaurant in Indianapolis by Indianapolis Monthly Magazine? Keystone Grill. If you want your fish any fresher, you'll have to get your feet wet.
Stay tuned immediately after the game for the Union Federal IU wrap-up show. We'll talk to Coach Norm Ellenberger, and we'll have the Subway Super Sub of the game. Plus, get the latest from the post-game press conference. That's immediately after the game here on WB4 Sports.
Indiana by one, second half. Ted, one of the things I think young teams are concerned themselves with is they don't want to make mistakes so they can pull out of the game, but that's really not the purpose to be out here. The purpose is, how am I going to win this game for my team? A.J. Guy needs to think that way.
Yeah, I think so, too, and I think that's a great point, because you go out there, you want to play, and so you don't want to make mistakes. If you make a mistake, you come out. But if you go out there with that attitude, you end up not getting anything done, you know? And Luke Recker kind of came in with the attitude last year that he was going to do whatever it took, and because of it, he was a very, very good player. I think you got to go out there with that offensive-minded, make things happen, you know? And we talked about developing a personality. I mean, you played this team for 20 minutes. You ought to have a pretty good idea of what they can do. Now it's time to go out there and do what you can do and try to win the basketball game.
Very good point right there. Let's see how Indiana responds. First 5 minutes of the second half. Good rebound there.
Tough catch right there.
Got rid of it well, though. And
good pass fake by Haseman.
And Guyton comes through with a three-point shot. Big play.
We talked about the little things right there. That pass fake cleared A.J. Guyton for a three-point. If he doesn't make the pass fake, A.J. Guyton doesn't get the open three.
Now Indiana by four. Shivers. Beat Recker on the dribble. Haste in the board. Here comes Guyton.
He's got to take it to the basket. See, he's always looking to give it up. Now, Indiana looks like going to come up with something. Maybe not. But A.J. Guyton has got to force things. He's got to take that ball, make somebody play defense. He automatically takes it to the free throw line, and he throws it back out. Doesn't make the team play defense.
Guyton right on Shivers. Tough pass on the angle that time. Out of bounds.
I mean, the thing I want you to think about is how many NBA teams would love if Michael Jordan would run it down the floor, get to the free throw line, and then throw it back out. Take a look at Stephen Scheffler inside. Watch how he uses his lower body. Bad passing angle right there. But I want you to think about that. How many teams in the NBA would love it if Jordan would come down and throw it back out? They'd love if that would happen, not force the action.
Guyton misses on that shot. Daniels down the middle. Recker tried to draw the foul.
A good no call right there.
Here comes Guyton. Looks, he got it to Lewis. Rebound and a layup. Mike
Papa Lewis is like, wow, Christmas right here. This is a quick gift. They want a timeout. It's going to be 20. Good start by Indiana as they build their lead to 6 points. Athletes in action call that quick timeout. Not happy with the way they've seen.
Take a look at Indiana the last time down. Michael Lewis, nice job going in, getting a little shorter. Steve Scheffler doesn't block out. And Michael Lewis, littlest man on the floor, goes in and says, thank you very much. I'll take those easy two. Nobody reacts to the basketball except Michael Lewis. We'll take them however we can get them, right, Mike?
So a good start by Indiana. They came out ready to play second half. Good hustle play by Lewis.
See David Daniels right there, just kind of shoves Lewis out of the way. He's played this game long enough to know that right there he draws the foul. And, you know, coach not real happy about that right there, but a lot of that has to do with David Daniels being smart. I mean, for the whole time he's kind of set this thing up, and then he gets the ball inbounds, he kind of dribbles into Lewis, and boom, they call a foul. Watch how he kind of dribbles into you. Smart player. When you're that size and built like that, you better be a smart player.
Scheffler inside. Missed it.
He's going to get it in, though, sooner or later.
And a foul, so he's got a chance for 3 points.
Let's watch him down low. Again, look at him clear out inside. Clears you out with his butt and his legs. He doesn't clear you out so much with his arms up top, but that way the official's not going to call things on him. Just a smart player. Excellent post player down inside. He's not a real naturally gifted basketball player. Like I said, he looks like a linebacker, but he's learned to play the game, and he's just he's been a tremendous player wherever he's been.
Here's Guyton on the drive, and a foul. Now he's approaching that basket.
Yeah, I mean, it's easy. He makes something happen. He draws a foul. You know, things like that. You continue to drive, draw fouls. You know, Indiana's going to be shooting 1-1. Those are little things, but those are the things that he, you know, he brings to the table. I mean, people have got to play him.
Here's Lewis on top.
Pace the record a little better job screening down inside. Guyton trying to get open, not getting a lot of help. That's
Shivers
a charge.
All the way in.
That's a charge.
And Guyton in good position.
Good position. Nice to see A.J. Guyton getting on the floor. He's not a guy that, when he was a freshman, he was going to be stepping there. Look at him. He steps right in there. That's good. That is really, really good right there. It's not easy when you're a little guy and you got a big 6'7 guy coming in to step right in there and take it.
Don't take the charge, Drill.
Excellent, excellent, right there. Those little things right there. That reminds me of Isaiah Thomas when he used to work in the triangle, what we called the triangle. He'd get the ball down inside, one little dribble, a lean. Now the next time down and do the same thing, they run at him, leaves the ball, somebody gets a layup.
Left Scheffler all alone. Now to Hagers. Missed it. Gladness had it. Wrecker went down. No call.
Good strong move by Robbie Eggers. Good no call by the official right there. Down inside. Got to be strong.
Wrecker goes up. And again, and a foul.
Stays with it.
Indiana good aggressive play. Much better now in the second half.
See Coach Knight talking to Steve Wilmer down on the sideline. Take a look at AJ inside. Little shot fake. Boom. You got two guys. Go around them. Up and over. Excellent shot. But the next time, you know, it's setting up for the next time that he does the same type thing. Now he's got three guys coming at him. He drops it off, gets a layup for somebody. He creates the offense inside when he tries to get to the basket. Coach Knight not happy about the no call last time down when Robbie Eggers ran over Wrecker.
20-second timeout is called. Wrecker missed on that free throw. Indiana comes over to the bench. The lead now 5. So Indiana's improved on that halftime lead. This 20-second timeout is brought to you by Spieth. Indiana returns quite a bit of scoring, rebounding, and assists from last year's team.
this early season can tell this team about the way they're going to play.
The one thing that, you know, you can see Indiana brings a lot back. The one thing they really don't have is a force inside. Just somebody that's a big body inside that's going to rebound, going to, you know, knock people off cuts when they cut through that middle. Until they get a guy like that, I think they're going to be a team that, you know, you really don't know a lot about.
Wrecker hits the second. And a little pressure by Gladness. Back cut. Read well by Gladness. He came to help. And the turnover.
Exactly right. William Gladness being in the right position right there forced that turnover.
Wrecker.
To get somebody open rather than coming out to the free throw line wanting the basketball. He needs to, like right here, after they pass, he can go out back screen for Luke Wrecker. Look for a back screen right here.
Lewis inside to Haston.
Excellent ball movement by Indiana. Good interior passing. Again, taking the ball to the basket. Somebody has to pick you up, drop off for the easy layup.
Comes Daniels. Way outside.
Good pass by Eggers.
Shivers can't get it. And Guyton comes away with it.
Robbie Eggers looking opposite right there. Knows that's where the open man is.
Wrecker. Off on that three. Gladness has it. And up quickly.
He's very, very quick inside. Got quick hands, quick feet.
Now it's the biggest lead of the game. 10. By Indiana. This hard, aggressive play. Shivers hits that three.
A good, smart play by AIA right there. Take it down inside where they've got the advantage with Scheffler. Then you have to double team, and then they pop it back out for the three-pointer.
Tipped away, Indiana ball. And much better play here early in the second half by the Hoosiers. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus. Right down on the block.
Again, a little pass fake and then the quick pass down inside when Gladness clears himself. He's gonna shoot two. And Indiana, after this sequence, when they come back down on defense, they have to know that athletes in action are gonna continue to pound that ball into Stephen Scheffler. Indiana's got to get a body behind him, and then as soon as the ball goes over, they either got to help down in or help over across, not leaving Shivers, because Shivers is the guy that's killing him right now. He's the guy, he's the three-point shooter. If you're going to leave somebody, you've got to leave somebody else, not him.
In the backcourt here, Michael Lewis is guarding Shivers. The coach called Shivers over, so Lewis just stayed right with him. It took a whole earful of the conversation the coach had with Shivers.
I'm telling you that Coach Knight said, we need to help, but we do not help off Shivers. Whoever's got him, stay with him.
He stayed with him right to the coach's bench. A drive and Lewis with the foul.
I'm going to call him with Daniel. With the hand down on the hip right there. Take a look at it. It's not a big foul right here, but you can see he's got the hand down on the hip. Really not much of a foul at all. It's a pretty cheap one right there.
He's on the drive. That's why there's no shots.
Lewis would like to keep him right down inside if at all possible.
Well, Scheffler wants that ball again on Haston. Here it comes.
He's going to get it. He's strong.
And Haston rebounds.
Good rebound right there. He's got some long arms.
Guyton.
And he needs to go right back over there and get it. He kind of runs away from the basketball. You'd like to see him.
Shot fake, and he gets the jumper. One dribble, and the shot.
Deadly off of that shot fake and that little dribble.
12 points now for Guyton, and he's got him quietly.
He's a guy that just has to get himself in the basketball game. I remember, 2 years ago, the weekend that he had Good block by Gladness coming from nowhere. Oh, good look. They're going to call the foul. That's the second dunk that Indiana's missed tonight. Recker missed the dunk, but excellent look by Michael Lewis right here. Good help. Indiana holds position, doesn't go up and slap. Gladness blocks. Recker out front. Well, you know, he's a great athlete and a great jumper, but if you can't dunk it, you got to lay it in, right? Isn't that what Coach used to say?
They've got the advantage of that rim that pulls down. If you and I could grab the rim, pull it down, and then lay it over the towel, that would have been easy, wouldn't it? That 9.5 feet just rolling in there.
We'll have to, you know, sometimes when we see Rector, we'll have to tell him, hey, you know, if you can't dunk it, you're going to have to lay it off the glass.
White block. I tell my kindergarten team, you've got to hit the white block there, and it'll roll in. Indiana now by 13, so steadily they've increased that one-point lead.
Ooh,
over the Hellers for the half. Outside shot, that was Hellman. Scheffler rebound. Look at the athlete. There's Recker. He pulls that one down.
You know, this is when you really want to be smart. You've got a good lead right here. Really make them play defense. Come down, use some clock, get a really good shot inside.
Turnover.
Instead, Indiana throws the ball away, and that's one reason Indiana hadn't been a very good team holding leads.
Shivers missed the shot, and that foul goes against Garrison, pushing on Guyton in second.
It's hard to see the push, but AJ knew he got pushed inside. I mean, again, we talked about personality early in the basketball game. Right here, you got a 13-point lead. If you come down and really make that defense work for 25, 30 seconds, and you end up getting a good shot, you get 2-3 points on the board right there. Excellent. Indiana doesn't get the basket, but right there, that's good offense, and that's one that Indiana's got to make.
Everything went well except the shot. Recker on the foul. Jared Odell will check back in. Boy, gets up high on that shot as well.
Yeah, he sure does. He's so quick getting to the basket. Seems like he has so many that are so close that roll around that basket. Put a little softer touch on him. Get the roll. Let's see, they're going to continue to pound it down in there. When they double team, he's going to throw off. So far, that's how they're getting their baskets down here on their offensive end.
Garrison with that jumper, lead is 11.
You know, Indiana had two opportunities to get that lead to 15, even 17. Didn't get it, now it's back to 11. Fortunate there, they kicked the ball out of bounds. Let's take a look at athletes in action. Scheffler continues to clear out, does a nice job getting the ball. And watch how he reads, they come over double team, he looks for the opening. Garrison opens himself up, buries the jump shot. Good offense by the athletes in action.
Lewis leaves now with 7 points. Rob Turner in for him. Hasten the shot is off. Scheffler pulls it down. And a foul as he gets pushed out of bounds.
We talk about recognition. I mean, Matt Heldman is guarding A.J. Guyton. Matt, not the quickest guy in the world. Great player, works very hard. But I think that's when, as a big guy, you really got to, you know, you got to go looking for A.J. Guyton, looking for Luke Recker, guys that can get points on the board, not taking 15-foot jump shots. That's when you're going to play if you get those guys open.
That's four now on Hasten. He comes out and Washington goes in. We talked earlier, Ted, about guys not trying to make mistakes. And the same thing when you just play caution. You have to recognize who's out there. Now that's the guy we got to go to. He's got an advantage. That's the next step they need to be in.
Exactly. And I think it's also important that A.J. Guyton recognize that he's the guy. Oh, that's a foul. Odell caught Steve Scheffler as he went up for the hook and kind of hooked his leg. But A.J. Guyton has to recognize it also. I mean, as a big guy, you go over to A.J. I'm going to get you open. We need you to score some points. You know, don't just get it, dribble it around, and pass it. We need you to create some offense here for it.
Now, Odell's back in the game, Ted. Give our audience a little better idea where Converse is. That first clue didn't really seal the deal, you know?
Are you telling me you don't know where Wapikon is?
No, I have not been through Wapikon in all my years.
Boy. have you missed out? I'll tell you what.
Boy, the cards and letters will come in from there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Now, Scott, it's up north of Indianapolis. Give me a little better direction.
It's up in the Kokomo. Converse would even be over closer to Mary in that area for people that are there.
And for old guys like me, the home of Monty Tau.
Oh, yeah, Oak Hill High School.
Tau.
Who was not only a great basketball player, but was a wonderful quarterback for the Oak Hill Golden Eagles.
That's enough on them, I think. All right, Indiana by 9. Give and goes have worked for the athletes, and any time a power move by Scheffler is going to work too. They're back in this ball game at 7.
And this is the things Indiana's really had problems with, losing leads after they've worked hard. I mean, they had a 13-point lead. See, A.J. not creating now. I mean, he's just standing out front dribbling the basketball. That's not a shot that Coach Knight's really looking for.
Guyton came away with it. Recker.
That's a better one there.
And it is 3 for Luke Recker.
Because he had a better look at the basket.
10 for Recker. 11 minutes left, second half.
Rob Turner has got to get up on his man and create some pressure. It's the second 3 we've seen Robbie Eggers carry tonight.
Eggers outside. Eggers 11 points. Makes up for Recker's 3 at the other end. Guyton floats, misses that one. And Athletes in Action will have it. They're making a comeback. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus. John Laskowski and Ted Kitchell from Bloomington as we cover Indiana's second and final exhibition game against the Athletes in Action. Robbie Eggers, 44, 11 points in tonight's game. They go with 3 rebounds.
2 3-pointers along with that. Wasn't a guy that really shot the basketball that much, but
he knows these rims.
Oh, yeah. Doing a good job in there.
Good game for Robbie.
Indiana trying to pressure the basketball. Athletes actually going to take it back inside. Eggers 3 for 3 from the 3-point line. Somebody better get a hand in his face.
He did it again, and the lead is 4 points for Indiana. Who's going to take control of the offense? Tough pass by Turner. He saves it, though.
Good read by Robbie Eggers, taking the cut away from A.J. Guyton. But you can see a lot of Indiana guys standing around, a lot of one-on-one moves right now. Not much going right for Indiana on the offensive end. This is when they need to pick up the defensive pressure, knock the ball away, try to get an easy basket some other way.
Scheffler, double team, dribbles out of it.
Threw that away.
16 turnovers now for the Athletes in Action. Press row gets a little excitement. Those guys never could catch, could they? That's why they're on the
press row, right? That's why they write about it.
Not that you or I ever dropped a pass. I mean, we don't have that on tape.
See if Indiana can get some good screening. You can see there's still a lot of people down inside. There's not a lot of room for shots, and Indiana, they're going to have to come down and take a couple threes, kind of clear things out, get some screens going on inside.
Garrison inside. Caught on the baseline.
Oh, he could shoot it.
He got that pass right through the baseline area without going out of bounds. And Hackham hits the 3-pointer. It's a 1-point game.
And remember, it wasn't long ago when it was 57 to, I think, 44. It was a 13-point lead, and Indiana had the basketball 2 times in a row looking to take that to 15. Indiana been outscored.
And a foul. Recker was moving toward the hoop. And Indiana will be in the bonus, so at least some shots here. That foul on Scheffler.
Yeah, been outscored 15-3 in about the last 3 minutes. You can see Dane Fife comes back. Not a big night. Hadn't seen the minutes that he saw the other night against the Melbourne team, but has 2 points.
like this lineup, though, with Recker, Guyton, and Fife in there. That's a lot of leadership, a lot of good quickness, good heady play. Now Lewis comes in.
Be interested to see. You see, we bring Lewis in. Now it's a very, very small team. We'll have to move Luke Recker down. He'll probably go over and guard either Garrison or Robbie Eggers, but I'm interested to see how Dane Fife reacts in the last 8 minutes. You know, we've got a really close game here. This is the type of game you would think that he would really thrive in. Being a coach's kid.
Recker hits that good screen that time by Eggers. Somebody called that one out, and Lewis hit the deck.
Talked about talking on defense.
That would help.
Michael Lewis will be down talking to somebody.
Inside, the foul on Fife. We'll talk about Indiana, a small team, how they match up with the athletes, but athletes next has to match up with them as well. Watch this pick.
Watch out, Robbie Eggers, and it's a good one right there. I mean, he doesn't do anything. He just sets a good, solid screen. There's nobody up there to help him out, and once the play stopped, Robbie Eggers came over and asked Michael Lewis, he says, are you all right? And they're kind of laughing about it right there along the lane.
There they are. Lewis said, who taught you to scream?
Where were you when I needed you? A
right
couple
here,
years,
baby,
years
right
ago.
Right on this court I learned how to scream, just like that. Indiana by two. Garrison at the line. He'll have another free throw.
No panic in the AIA team. They play a lot of basketball games. They know that they shoot the ball very well from three-point range, so there's plenty of time. When they were down 13, and it only took them a couple of minutes, and they were right back in the basketball game.
This team 4-2 on their trip so far.
Still a lot of standing by Indiana. Let's see, they need to create some problems inside.
Recker, Lewis, that touch pass nearly stolen by Hackham. And Indiana's got a ball game, 7:52 left. What will they do? You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus. It's Indiana by one, 7:52 left, exactly the type of exhibition game the Hoosiers were looking for, a physical, tough game.
Robbie Eggers has really gotten this athletes and action team back. You can see Scheffler gets double teamed, throws it out, Robbie Eggers spots up. People wondered if he could hit that three when he was here at Indiana. He didn't hit a lot of them at Indiana, but he's hit three for three tonight, so he's a guy that obviously could shoot the basketball. 11-2 for the athletes in action in the last 4 minutes.
Well, Indiana needs to put some points on the board. And there's a guy to go to. Missed. Garrison has it. Chance now for athletes in action to take the lead.
Got a good shot by Luke Recker. That's basically what they're looking for. See, the defensive pressure, not what it was. You can see they're able to catch. They're able to look. There's not a lot of pressure on the basketball. Important. You know, when you talk about defensive pressure, that you can't catch and you can't look down inside. You have somebody in your face all the time.
There's a good rebound. Gladness with good position.
Not only a good rebound, but a good block out.
Guyton open.
Bingo.
Oh, just short. Tipped out of bounds. Indiana will retain possession.
Indiana with a break right there. That ball's off record. You can see he kind of slides away knowing they got the call.
Scheffler back in. That'll give us more strength inside.
These are shots that Indiana's got to hit.
Chuck Badger voicing his opinion about that last call. Indiana just 5 of 11 from 3-point, and the athletes have made 9 3-pointers tonight.
The 3-pointers definitely, they were 5 for 9 at halftime. It's definitely kept them in the basketball game.
Fight. And great pass to Gladness for the layup.
But again, it's the penetration. I mean, anybody that gets penetration, you don't have to be the quickest guy on the floor. He's worked his way around there, created something, dropped off the pass. Wayne Gladness, just an easy basket.
12 for Gladness, nearly stolen by Fife.
Good read, good recognition by Dane Fife right there.
Eggers, a 3-point shot again as he's left alone. Game tied. Last time was 12-12. Now 64 all. 6:15 left in the game.
Travel.
Gladness moved both feet before he dribbled. Daniels checks back in.
Once you cut across that lane, you got to be ready to receive that basketball. Know what you're going to do with it when you do get it. Robbie Eggers, take a look at him right there. 4 for 4 from the 3-point line. Just an outstanding night. Great return to Assembly Hall.
3-point lead for the athletes in action.
There's still a lot of people standing around in that lane. You got to clear things out. Indiana had the advantage right there, and then Guyton gave it back to him when he passed off. He's got to take that shot.
Lewis hits it from the outside.
Good job by Michael Lewis. Good shot fake. Probably does as good a job as anybody, he and Guyton, as far as clearing themselves with that shot fake. He's starting to step up and take the jump shot now.
Tied again at 67.
Good pressure by Fife that time.
Scheffler has the offensive rebound, double team. Eggers. Right in front of the AIA bench.
Are you kidding me?
Well, it's 5 of 5 from the 3-point line. Woo. 20 points for Robbie Eggers.
Wow.
And a foul this time, Eggers, as he tried to prevent Gladness from getting the ball. This crowd is buzzing.
20 points, 5 of 5 from the 3-point line. Wow.
We all have those days, you know, you throw it up there, you know it's going in, and Robbie is having his today.
He's doing a nice job taking a good look at it, and there's no question, every one of them
dead end,
going right in the middle.
Eggers got 20 points now, and he's played 19 minutes. That is scoring. Gladness hits.
This is a Michael Jordan type stat.
Indiana trails it by 2.
Indiana's going to win basketball games this year. I think they're going to win them on the defensive end, though. They've got people that can score points, but they've got to do a better job playing defense, pressuring the basketball.
Scheffler. Threw it away. No, Hackham got it.
Hackham saved him right there. He's throwing it to Robbie Eggers.
Good position. Scheffler just held the body there and kept Haston from stealing the basket.
Haston really did a nice job. I think that's going to be his 5th foul, but he did a good job trying to release to the basketball. But against Steve Scheffler, you can see he just holds him off, and then Haston releases to the basketball, but Scheffler too smart. He gets over there, has the position. He's a very difficult guy to play. I mean, when we talk about playing defense before people get the basketball, he's a guy that you just cannot let him get position on you, because once he gets you behind him, you're big problem.
4 points, 3 rebounds for Haston. But learned quite a bit out there playing a big, strong guy like Scheffler. 16 now for Scheffler. He's above his average. And the lead, 4 points now, 4:23 left in the game, and Indiana's got some work to do.
Well, they couldn't hold a lead. Let's see how they are trying to fight back and get the lead.
Wrecker's the go-to guy in that lineup now. Lewis has to dish it off.
AIA falling back into the a zone. Oh, tough pass. What a great catch.
Oh, he puts it in.
Those hands right there just saved a turnover for Luke Wrecker, because that ball was headed out of bounds. It's a really soft pause right there. Brought that one back in. A nice little fake and basket. That's a 10-second call.
Good defense by Lewis, and the turnover. Indiana's coming back, a chance to tie this up. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus. Play of the game brought to you by Synergy PSI, where energy comes to life. Robbie Eggers, even though he's got a different kind of red on, 20 points, 3-point shooting like that, grants him the honor tonight.
Excellent choice. He's had a career night, and we all know what a great kid he is. Had a great career here at Indiana, and it's nice to see him come out and play well. You'd like to see him play well against somebody else.
Washington, great move inside, lost control, now a steal. Daniels has it.
Yeah, they got to take care of the basketball. When they have it down on their end, they're going to call Dane Fife for the push.
And that'll be free throws and the double bonus as Indiana picks up their 10th team foul. So, good shot. Let's see if that's correct. Bob Knight on the Indiana bench.
It's interesting, on the 10-second call, the athletes and action coach was not happy with the call. Basically, Steve Wilmer said, look at the 24-second clock, and if you looked up at it, it was 24 seconds. So, 35-second clock, it was down to 24, so 11 seconds had run off. And that's basically why they called the 10-second call. Heads-up play by the official.
Indiana down three.
Got to know that somebody's there. Somebody has to be open.
And that's on Robbie Eggers' side. Gladness with the position. Indiana really trying to go inside. Of course, that'll get him to the free throw line. 1-1 now for Gladness.
Get to the free throw line. Now you got to knock these in. It'll also clear up and give Indiana some better looks at the basket. Wouldn't be surprised if we might see A.J. Guyton back in the game in the last 3 minutes.
Gladness hits a big one there. There's A.J. Been on the Indiana bench for a while now in the second half. Gladness missing
that one right there. Garrison up strong to get that rebound. Daniel, that dribbles right into you. There's no way to play defense against a smart kid handling the basketball because he's just going to create great problems. Gladness grabbed it.
Scheffler is strong, rare to steal that ball from him. Gladness picks up the foul. Now it'll be two shots for Scheffler. On the first one. First one he missed, now 10 of 11 for Scheffler from the line.
Coach Knight wants a timeout, probably a 20. Looks like he's going to draw something up real quick.
Great experience for this team in a close game they may have here soon. The rest of November, December, draw a quick play, see if they can run it.
I think it's interesting that the players that he has on the floor, you take a look at the athletes and action schedule.
This 20-second timeout brought to you by Spieth. They won their first two. Jimmy Cruz handed them a loss at Evansville a few days ago. They beat Valparaiso. They'll be at the RCA Dome this weekend. And they lost to Illinois 2 days ago, defeated Bradley last night. And now they're in a scrape with Indiana, and they have the three-point lead, just under 3 minutes to go.
Some type of set play right here. Let's see what Indiana's looking to do.
Double screen, looks like on this side for Fife. Now they go to him.
Looked like they were trying to clear Dane Fife. Nothing there. Oh, good pass by Washington.
Excellent look. Did you see how he watched? The guy that they were looking for was Fife. He cut through, took the defense with him, and Washington read the defense, found the open man. Excellent job.
1 point game now, Indiana trail.
Don't want to get too anxious. Got to play good, solid position defense. Don't let anybody get up. He's dragging that foot.
He did.
Well, referee's right on top of him. Saw him drag it right in front of the bench.
Indiana chance to take the lead. Substitution 33 is Julian Winfield in for the athletes in action.
Same play is what the loop breakers call them. Set it up, run it. See, they flash Lynn Washington in. Oh, excellent. Oh, he got fouled.
Missed the shot. Eggers there.
William Gladness got shoved right there. No call. I mean, it's one he still should have gotten the basket, but he should have had a three-point opportunity because he got pounded down low.
Scheffler. Timeout is called by athletes in action. Boy, they just gotten that ball right into Scheffler, 3 feet from the basket. Indiana trails it by one. They need to score. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus.
for the Athletes in action, 74-73. Take a look, Indiana's offense. Right here, they're going to get a basket. Good job, good pass by Washington to Gladness. The one thing with Gladness, you know, you wonder why he misses a lot of those shots inside. Take a look when Steve Scheffler has the ball inside, how he takes it up with both hands on the basketball, doesn't release that other hand off the ball until the last second. Gladness, you know, goes up with one hand on the ball a lot of times. A lot of times the ball just, he loses it out of his hands, can't control it, and that's why a lot of times he'll miss some of those easy ones that you feel like that he should be making.
All right, all set. Landon Hackham checked in at that timeout. Big possession here, 24 seconds on the clock. On the shot clock, I should say. Minute and a half to go in the game.
Much bigger athletes in action. Oh, right there. Good. Good job by Hackham as far as reading what the defense is doing. Down low, the defense has got to see that and be over there to help when they're out there pressuring.
The layup makes it a three-point lead. 1:15 to go. Washington in the lane. Double-team Recker for three. Yes, he got it.
I think if you take a look at that, it looked like his toe was on the line when he got ready to spot up.
Tie game, 1 minute to go.
But they gave him the three. It looked like from my angle that his toe was on the line, but it's three on the scoreboard.
Scheffler, Eggers.
Good job by Gladness using his quickness to get over there in front of Garrison.
14 seconds to shoot, 43 on the game clock. All tied up.
Take a look. Can't really tell from this angle. It sure looked like it from the angle I was sitting on that his toe was on it, but. Good hustle by Recker, and there's Dane Fife to pick it up. Good hustle by Recker and Dane Fife.
Big play, and came at the defensive end for Indiana. Timeout is called by Athletes in Action. Luke Recker has brought this crowd to its feet. It's Indiana by two. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus. In the game sponsored by KeyBank, help at every turn. It's the play you just saw.
Take a look, good hustle. Robbie Eggers should have grabbed that basketball. There's no problem. We saw Luke Recker earlier grab the ball in the backcourt on an out-of-bounds play. But great hustle by Luke Recker. Dane Fife picks it up for the easy basket, but the good hustle is what got Indiana the basketball.
There's some excitement there by Recker after his good play. Now Indiana's got to play the defense.
Don't expect the Athletes in Action to panic here. They've been in the situation many a time. They'll spread it out. They'll get it inside. They'll spot Hackham out. Oh, they take a quick shot.
And Lewis grabbed the jersey. And Hackham will go to the line. He was inside.
Could be
the three-point line.
Two-shot foul rather than three. And that's about the third time tonight Michael Lewis has got caught with his hand on the hip. I think that time they felt like he was grabbing the jersey.
And that came from the referee under the basket. He had the best angle to see that. So Hackham at the line.
You could pretty much count these two.
And why would you say that?
He's only shooting 93%. I remember the first time Indiana played Miami of Ohio when he was playing there. I remember my son on the way home, he said, did you see that one guy, that Hackham, shoot the basketball? And ever since then, I've remembered him. He's just a wonderful shooter, got great rotation, really shoots the basketball. You see, they'll take him out for defensive purposes here, get a little bigger, quicker man in there.
All right, shot clock is off, 27 seconds to play, and Indiana wants a timeout to talk about it. Bob Knight and Steve Wellmer in a discussion. It's a full timeout. Score tied. Indiana possession. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus, featuring intrastate rivals when Indiana will host Indiana State. Action gets underway at 7 o'clock on most of these ESPN Plus stations. Indiana ball. Length of the court. Fife takes it out of bounds. A.J. Guyton now in for Michael Lewis. Recker, Guyton, Fife, Washington, and Gladness.
The reason you bring Guyton is because he can create his own shot. You don't have to have somebody screening to get him open, which you might have to. You might have to create your own shot here at the end of the game.
10 seconds. Guyton in control. Now Fife. 5 seconds. Drecker shot to win it.
Nope.
Washington.
OT.
It is overtime as Drecker tried a shot that went off the rim. And it will be overtime in Bloomington.
The one good thing about that is you feel like Indiana really, you know, they didn't really get the shot they're probably looking for, but they didn't leave any time for a rebound and athletes in action to have a chance to call timeout and go to the other end. So coach has to be happy about that.
Guyton let some time run off the clock at the point and then began at about 8.5 seconds.
You see Wrecker's going to curl around. He's going to come all the way. Fife looking for him. He tries to get it to Gladness, but Drecker comes off, actually has the shot, really a pretty good look at it. Washington with the rebound, but can't get it back up on the basket before time runs out.
And a 5-minute overtime.
I mean, I hate to harp on it, but that's the time when you'd like to see A.J. Guyton really kind of get down into the free throw line, make the defense, bring the defense to him, goes up to shoot the basketball, and if he draws, then he can pass off, and it creates other shots for other people. Indiana was in an overtime in the NCAA last year against Oklahoma. Kind of a similar situation. They had a big lead. They let Oklahoma come all the way back. Let's hope that it has the same type of final.
Indiana won that game against Oklahoma. There's Steve Scheffler. He's had a big game, not as big as Robbie Eggers. He's made all of his three-point shots. He's been pretty quiet here the last 5 minutes of the game. So five more minutes of action, at least. Indiana goes with Fife and Guyton, Gladness, Drecker, and Lynn Washington. Positives, Ted, not a big rebounding difference between these two teams. We feared Indiana would take the short end of that.
Exactly. That's the point I was just getting ready to bring up. I thought Indiana's done a nice job on the boards. They've blocked out, rebounded very well.
And the tip back to Eggers. Down low, Scheffler. Over to help. So Scheffler will be at the line.
Hard to see exactly who might have got him. It did look like he got fouled down inside, but there was about three guys in front of him. Once you got him surrounded like that, I mean, Steve Scheffler, not a guy that's going to jump up over the top of you and hit that soft little jump shot. I mean, most of his shots come from 2, 3 to 5 feet out. So if you got him boxed in, he'll probably pass the ball back out if you give him a chance.
It's both of those. And a two-point athletes in action lead. Here comes Guy.
He's looking to pass the ball rather than create. Makes it easy on Daniels out there playing defense. You see Drecker gets tripped.
And that'll be free throws for Drecker.
See, Coach Knight wants the ball in Dane Fife's hand so he can get A.J. Guyton down inside running off screens. From what we heard up here, I think that Dane Fife got that message and will probably get the ball the next time down the floor.
I think you're right. Record short on that free throw. And that's a big one. Hackham comes back in for offensive possession.
Everybody on the floor needs to be aware who's in the basketball game. You know they're going in and back out. Hackham, an excellent shooter.
And Record hits the second. Indiana trails it by one. 4.5 left. A.J. on Daniels. Hackham and Scheffler on the same side. Garrison. steal by Gladness.
Well, Indiana couldn't come up with it. Got the hands on the basketball.
Five to shoot.
Good defense.
Oh, got a shot. Beckham nearly lost that ball and banked it in.
Good defense by Dane Fife. Did everything he could.
And then sometimes they just go in. Wrecker, or Lewis, is down. And that foul. Sorry, that's Fife. Dane Fife down. So Fife will be at the line. Garrison knocked him down.
Good, smart play. Let's take a look at the other end. You can see Fife in this position. You know where the shot clock's way down. You've got him exactly where you want him. And he throws up a prayer, and it was answered.
Fife hits the free throw.
That's a big free throw. That's a good, smart play down there. Set a screen. The guy comes into you a little aggressively, goes down, gets the call. Get Indiana back within one, and does. Those are two big free throws in a game like this. Tight game, Freshman steps up, knocks him down.
Indiana trails by one. 3:35 left. Packer. Long Garrison there. New possession.
That's part of the problem. Oh, good quickness.
Washington now
got to take it.
It's a breakaway. That's called by Welmer.
They're going to call it on Robbie Eggers. Basically what happened here, Dane Fife is kind of blocking on the other side, not letting Robbie Eggers get to Guyton. And you don't want to be, you can't hold the guy, but he's basically just kind of running in his way. Robbie Eggers kind of grabbed a hold of him. Take a look at it right here. You can see he sees a smart play. Smart play right there. He's just getting in his way. You can see Robbie Eggers goes right over the top of him. I'm a little surprised they called the intentional, because, you know, I can see him calling the foul, but they called the intentional.
Fife hits his third in a row. That means Indiana will get the ball and the two free throws. So this could turn out to be a big play.
Big free throws right here. He's got an excellent job.
Made both. That's four in a row. Now Indiana has possession and a one-point lead.
People at home wondering about Dane Fife, I think it shows a tremendous amount of confidence. He has been in there since the 8-minute mark of regulation play. That tells me a lot of what Coach Knight thinks about this guy as far as handling the basketball in clutch situations.
Wrecker on top now. Guyton trying to get open. Swings the baseline. See if he gives it up. He's looking to score this time. There's the move. There's the shot. Just off and a foul. So Guyton will go to the line.
Just whenever he really attacks the basket, good things happen for Indiana.
And you saw Isaiah do that so many times.
Oh, yeah. Isaiah was just, one of the greatest players that's ever played here and maybe ever played. But, he was just such a great guy to play with because he created so many problems for the defense.
Oh, Guyton rolled that one in. Looks like it was going to be short. 13 now for Guyton.
Yeah, you got a timeout.
Long. And he hits both. Now Indiana, a three-point lead.
Now let's see what type of personality we're going to play with on defense with a three-point lead. 3 minutes to go. We're going to get tough, make it very difficult for them to throw passes. You can see they get a quick look. Hackham ties it up.
Fife got caught behind a pick. Hackham doesn't need much time.
And you can't just look at Dane Fife in that situation. Somebody's setting screens there, so if your guy's setting a screen, you've got to come off the screen, get out, and you've got to help him.
Wrecker gets rid of it just in time.
You cannot let Hackham shoot jump shots.
2:40 left, Fife fake. The Wrecker off. And they say Washington hit it out of bounds. Athletes in action, ball. Indiana couldn't get that one to drop. Five told again, stay with Hackham.
You know, that's a double screen he's getting ready to come off of. See, there's another screen.
Scheffler with the rebound. And the travel as he pulled that foot. 20 turnovers now, so good pressure by Indiana has kept them in this game, and they're a big turnover. 2:15 to go, game tied.
Dane Fife, not in an easy position, chasing a guy like Hackham around. It's like you know, people used to chasing Steve Alford around, coming off three or four screens. I mean, just not an easy task.
Here's Guyton. Wrecker, Indiana can run some clock. 2 minutes left.
You don't want to run too much. You want to get a good shot.
Step right into it. Luke Wrecker left the three.
You know what kind of personality he's got.
He wants the ball when the game's on the line.
He wants that ball. If he could, you know, he's trying to get the rest of the team to have that same type of personality.
Daniels answers at the other end off the dribble.
Coach Knight just switched Dane Fife onto Daniels. Fife turns his head, looks down inside, and as soon as he does that, buries the jump shot on it.
Guyton inside, now to Wrecker, three. He's got two in a row. Luke Wrecker wants that ball.
Wow.
Daniel on Guyton now.
Look at Washington. Washington doing a great job fighting Steve Sheffield. Look at him fight, not letting him get to the ball. Excellent job by Lynn Washington inside.
Steps out and a push on Washington on the dribble there. Washington went to step out to.
Here we take go. A look inside. Look at Sheffield. He's going to try to come across the lane. This is what I'm talking about, playing defense before the guy gets it. Right there. See, Sheffler wants to come across to that block. Not able to. You can see they get Washington with the push right there. After all the pushing and shoving going on the floor. They get him with the little bump. Look at the free throws. Indiana 18 of 24. Athletes in action, only 8 of 20. That's kind of surprising. That can't be right. Sheffler's hit.
Yeah.
Sheffler's hit 11 of 12 himself. Yeah, that can't be right.
And Daniels hits two there. It's a one-point game, 1 minute to go. Indiana leads by one, but they'll have to shoot one more time at least. Fife gets around Hackham, lays it to Washington.
What a great play by Lynn Washington, but it's all set up by the freshman, Dane Fife. Did an excellent job, got the advantage. Got the advantage on his defender, took it inside. Look at him, he gets the advantage, he doesn't back it off, takes it right in, and this is strength right here, folks, because you got two people coming at you. Good dish, gives it right where he needs it. Bang! And those are two strong guys. Eggers and Sheffler both come at him. He dunks it in over the top of them. That's the personality Coach Knight's looking for.
There we go, you're exactly right. 10 points now, 8 rebounds for Washington. Again, not real flashy, but boy, a good solid player to have in there.
Well, he's one of those guys you love to play with.
He makes the play there, hits the free throw, and Indiana now the 4-point lead with 47 seconds to go. You're watching Big Ten Basketball from ESPN Plus.
Indiana comes up with a big play on the offensive end. Now, defensively, you really can't let down here. I mean, they're probably going to get a quick shot up there. You just cannot let them hit a three-pointer. Now, if they get inside and they get a two-pointer, you know, make them earn it, but you can't give them a three-pointer.
There's the layup by Garrison. 2 second, 2.5 second differential on the clock. So does the athletes in action foul? It looks like Chuck Badger is signaling he wants the foul, so we can get the ball back.
Coach Knight wants the ball in Guyton's hands and Wrecker's hands. They're the two best free throw shooters for Indiana.
And Wrecker gets fouled, 23 seconds left.
Well, Dane Fife probably doesn't look too bad right now. He's hit 4 in the last couple minutes. Again, Indiana, not a real good job of recognizing. Once Sheffler got the ball there, you can kind of see that he really wasn't moving to the basket. He was looking to pass. No need to come up and double team him when you've got him under control. As Wrecker sticks in the big free throw.
3-point lead now for Indiana.
I mean, you double team Sheffler when needed. That was long.
Get back away.
Smart play by Sheffler. White, don't take the chance of giving the referee the chance to call it.
Will it be double overtime? The athletes need a 3-point shot. 10 seconds.
Shot. He got it.
And he got fouled.
Did he call a charge? No basket?
Oh, he did call a charge. No basket. And wow. Five. Let's watch.
Wow.
That
take
one.
A look at it right here. Great shot by Hackham. Good position, though, by Dane Fife right there. There's no doubt he's in position. That's a call that the officials usually aren't going to make at that point in the game. Indiana still must get the ball inbound.
They do. Guyton fouled immediately.
I mean, would you agree with me? Most officials usually aren't. They're going to kind of let that play go.
I mean, there you see Chuck Badger. I mean, it could have been a three-point shot and a free throw.
Yeah.
It really would have changed the outcome of this game. But Fife was leaning back all the way, that's for sure, and Hackham initiated the contact. It's easy to see that on the replay, but not as easy to see it in live action.
Yeah, exactly.
Because you knew they were going for a three-point shot.
I mean, if you're the official, you see the offensive player obviously leaning. Dane Fife in excellent position right there to get the call.
Boy, he's made some big plays in overtime.
I thought that was interesting that Coach Knight brought him in with 8 minutes to go and hasn't taken him out. He obviously, we talked about him being a quarterback, being in a position to being the guy that likes to make the play or get the ball where it needs to be, and done an excellent job in the last minutes of this basketball game tonight to get Indiana a victory.
Guyton hits both. Daniels right through everybody. Hackham hits the three. Washington takes it out. All
oh, you got to touch it. You got to touch
Gladness
it.
Gladness does. And that'll do it. Indiana wins at 97-95 in a wild game, but a very good game as you see the team congratulate each other on center court. Be watching ESPN Plus on Saturday, November 14th for a game for getting congratulations from Ron Felling. It's the final, 97-95. So long from Bloomington.